Good morning, Flint Hill family. Today is Friday, January the 15th, 2021. And it's a very special day today. Today is actually Martin Luther King's real birthday. Even though we're not going to celebrate it until Monday, we thought it'd be neat to go ahead and actually give him a shout out for his birthday on his real birthday, which is today. This is our first live podcast for Flint Hill. As you see, we all have microphones. We actually have headphones too, but we're not using those today. We've got a new computer. We've got a new webcam. All kinds of new stuff going on here at Flint Hill. Can't wait for the news crew to get back to be able to help us out with this equipment. We think it's going to be really nice. Our podcast today is going to be a little different. We're not going to be discussing in depth. We're going to be telling you and giving you things to think about, okay? And these might be some things you can come back and do your own documentary to share back with us, okay? So let's get started talking about our day-to-day, which is Martin Luther King's birthday. I'm going to give you some facts about Martin Luther King, and you see if you know, if you remember these or have ever heard of these. And then we're going to pass it off to Miss Rebels and then to Miss Cannon to finish us up. And we hope you enjoy our little salute here to Martin Luther King's birthday. Martin Luther King was born on January the 15th in 1929. And he was born right here in Georgia, Atlanta, Georgia, okay? So that's what's one of the other, one thing that is really special about Martin Luther King to us. He is from Georgia. When he was a child, he was a very bright young man, and he was very eager and hardworking. And that helped him along to where he went on to college and earned a degree and just continued his education on and on. He was also a Baptist minister, and he was a Baptist minister here at a church that is in Atlanta also. It's called Ebenezer Baptist Church, and that is also where there is a museum there for him now, and it's my understanding that you can go there and you can go through the museum, and well, it might not be able to right now because of the COVID restrictions, but we were going to look that up to see if that is something that you could do as a virtual field trip. And I forgot to do it yesterday. But we're going to try to do that today to see if that's something you guys could do on your own. Martin Luther King became the leader of the American Civil Rights Movement. And he put together peaceful demonstrations and peaceful marches to try to push our country into this through the civil rights movement, so everyone had the same rights and the same capabilities and the same opportunities. And that was what he was noted for as far as his leadership abilities in that movement. And there were many others from our state that were in that too, but we're just honoring Martin Luther King today. In 1963, he marched in Washington and made his famous speech, "I Have a Dream." And we're going to hear a little bit more about that in just a moment. But that speech made him famous. And he also received the Nobel Peace Prize for the work that he did with the civil rights movement. So Martin Luther King was a great guy. He was a great gentleman. And he pushed us through many hard times. And he's just an amazing person, boys and girls, that we think you need to know about. Now, I'm going to pass this off now to Miss Rebels, who's going to give us some quotes that are famous of Dr. Martin Luther King's.
Okay, so one of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s most famous speeches, as Miss Bates said, is "I Have a Dream" speech. And in this speech, Martin Luther King Jr. said, "In the process of gaining our rightful place, we must not be guilty of wrongful deeds." So in that, he is saying that we should always be peaceful and do the right thing. And that's kind of what Martin Luther King stood for, was for peace and for always making the right decisions. He also said, "I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, and that all men are created equal." Lastly, I'd like to tell you that he also said, I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. Ms. Cannon?
So this week, I want you guys to think about what you would thank Martin Luther King Jr. for. What would you ask him? What kind of questions would you ask him about? And what would you want to tell him about what you would want, like him to know? What would you want to tell him, Ms. Bates?
Boys and girls, you know, you could even take time to write a letter. If you were able to write a letter to Martin Luther King, what would you want to tell him about or ask him? Think about those questions that Ms. Cannon gave you. That would be a great opportunity for you to express yourself and to think through the process and get to know Martin Luther King on a more personal level. We hope you enjoyed our podcast today, celebrating Martin Luther King's birthday. We're going to move on now, as I want to just let you know that Monday is the holiday. That's the day that we really observe Martin Luther King's birthday. And we will not have school. There will be no virtual school. And also, by now, I'm sure you know that we will not be back in person next week. Okay, so we're going to have choice boards and packets for the students that are normally in person. If you are virtual, you will still have a virtual schedule, and you will adhere to that, and your teachers are going to let you know all about that. I'll be posting the choice boards on the Flint Hill website today. I will be posting those, and you can access all that. So I wanted to make sure you understood that, you know, we're still on short-term lockdown or shutdown, excuse me. Get my words right. So you know that. Boys and girls, don't forget about the Reading Bowl with Malcolm Mitchell. Make sure you're keeping up with your minutes, and you're turning those into your teachers so they can turn them into Miss McNulty. That's really, really important. I want to give everyone a huge shout out before I go to the shout outs. Dr. DiNardo told us yesterday that she has just been overly, overly impressed with the amount of work that has been turned back in by Flint Hill students during the short-term shutdown. So that is an awesome compliment, guys. I know you're doing a good job. We all know you are. And we want you to know that we really do appreciate it. And we can't wait till we're back in person together so we can start having more fun and doing more things with you here at Flint Hill. But until that time, boys and girls, remember the three W's: wear your mask, wash your hands, and watch your distance. And hopefully we will be back in school very, very soon. And now let's move on into our weather and our pledge, and then I will come back after our story. This was our story, excuse me. Then I will come back and we'll do the Wolfpack shout outs for the week. Have a great day, boys and girls, and I'll see you back in just a few minutes.
Good morning, Flint Hill. Chief Meteorologist Memoji in the Wolfpack Weather Center. Today is Friday, January 15th, 2021. I thought, since today is actually Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s birthday, and we won't be here on Monday, that I would share a few landmarks that were really special in the life of Dr. Martin Luther King. Where I'm standing now is the Washington Mall in Washington, D.C. This is the spot where Dr. Martin Luther King made his I Have a Dream speech. This location is actually much closer to us. This is just a few miles up the road in Atlanta, Georgia. This is the actual house that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was born in. Again, it's in Atlanta, just a few miles up the road. This is at the King Center, which is just a few miles up the road from the home where he was born. There is a museum and memorabilia from the life of Dr. Martin Luther King and his wife, Coretta Scott King. I hope you guys have enjoyed seeing these special landmarks, and I hope you have a fabulous day. I will have your local forecast coming up in just a moment. Unlike the landmark photos, which had beautiful sunny weather, this is more like what our weather is going to be today. So that sun and warm temperatures I was hoping would come in for the weekend didn't quite make it. We have a 60% chance of rain today with a high of 50 degrees, and then only going to get colder for Saturday and Sunday. Although there's no rain in the forecast for those days, the temperatures are quite chilly. Guys, I hope you have a fabulous Friday, and we will remember we're out of school on Monday, so we will see you back here on Tuesday morning. Enjoy your weekend.
Please stand and pay respect to our flag and country.
I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America,
the Republic,
which it stands,
one nation under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You know you make me wanna shout, kick my heels up and shout, throw my hands up and shout, throw my head back and shout. Come on now, don't forget to say you will. Don't forget to say yeah, 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 yeah.
Welcome back, boys and girls, and welcome to the Wolfpack Shoutouts. Miss Ella's having a little fun there with one of our new little toys we've got to work with here in the newsroom. Want to give some shout outs today. Can't wait to get for you to hear about them. The first one goes out to Enrique White Jr. for having a great first half of the school year. Let's finish strong. Yay! Caden to Camden for being the best brother ever. Awesome. Aaliyah Johnson, because she's always helping me with everything and she's been there for me. Wonderful. Miss Golston's class is getting a shout out. It says, super shout out to all you epic readers. Our class has read 2,100 books and our reader pillar is growing and growing. And I am so proud of all of you. Good job, Miss Golston's class. Hope McGonigal, thank you for showing up last week every day. Good job.
Yay!
Kaylee Hedrick, thank you for showing up on Zoom last week. Kaquan Cooper, thank you for being such a good friend.
Woo!
Andrew, you are smart and you are brave and keep up the good work.
Good job.
All of Miss Parker's first grade class, excellent job on turning in assignments from last week.
Woo!
Jalea Zhang, thank you for being my best friend and helping me through a rough time.
Woo!
Miss Smith for being the best teacher ever.
Yes.
Miss Everett for being the best teacher ever.
Good job.
Miss Everett for being the best teacher ever and that she got me to be better at math.
Woo!
This one goes out to Miss Christopher. Thank you for helping me with my art skills.
Woo!
To Miss Kitchens for being a great teacher and a great example to all our virtual third grade.
Woo!
Miss Kanicki, you are the best.
Yes!
Miss Levitt, thank you for teaching me brand new things.
Woo!
Awesome job, boys and girls.
Woo!
This is what we need around Flint Hill. We need good stuff. We need good compliments and for everybody to find good in people, okay? So, boys and girls, keep up this good work. Next week, we're going to have a day where it's National Compliment Day. And if I'm thinking about it right, I think it's next Friday, which is wonderful because that's our shout out day. So you put those shout outs in, boys and girls. Let people know that they're doing a good job at Flint Hill. You guys stay strong and we will see you back here on Tuesday. Have a great weekend, boys
Woo!
And girls.